हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ओवर न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी फॉर क्लास 11th एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन। सो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर न्यूमेरिकल एंड हेयर द होल चैप्टर इज बेस्ड ऑन द फॉर्मूला दैट इज एसेट्स इज इक्वल टू लाइबिलिटीज प्लस कैपिटल। दैट इज द बेसिक अकाउंटिंग फॉर्मूला ऑफ अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन। बट फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस फॉर्मूला देयर आर two main concept, assets and liabilities. So here some items are given that included in the assets, like machinery, cash, bank, stock, debtors, furniture, shares, all comes under the heading of assets. Here some liabilities are also given that the first one is creditor, second one outstanding expense, bill payable and many more. Here, for understanding the concept, one question is given that show the accounting equation on the basis of the following transaction and prepare a balance sheet on the basis of last new equation. Here, some points are given. Mukesh started business with cash, purchase goods for cash, purchase goods on credit, purchase furniture for cash, paid rent, received commission, withdraw cash for private use, sold goods on credit, and the cost price of goods that is 30,000 and the selling price is 40,000. Paid to creditors, purchase goods for cash rupees 20,000 and credit rupees 30,000. Sold goods, the costing of goods that is 10,000 and the costing of goods also 15,000, that both the goods are sold at a profit of 20%. Rent received, invested in the shares, paid cash for household expenses and deposit into bank. That is the whole question. Now, one by one, we are going to discuss all the points, how they deal with the accounting equation. So, first of all, what is the format of accounting equation? Here, the format of accounting equation is given that serial number, transactions, assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. We know that what is the assets. Before understanding this concept, we are already discussed the elements that included in the assets and some elements that included in the liabilities. So, for understanding all the elements, now we consider the question. So, first of all, point number one. Mukesh started business with cash. It means that Mukesh is the owner of the business. And the owner invests money in the business, that means capital. So it affects two accounts, cash account as well as capital account. So how it transacts with the accounting equation? Here it is. First of all, serial number one. The point of question, that is Mukesh started business with cash. That affects two accounts, cash and capital. So cash comes under the heading of assets and capital is the main concept. So that single transaction affects two accounts. First one is cash and second one is capital. So Mukesh started business with cash, that affects two accounts, cash account plus capital account. The second equation is purchase goods for cash. Purchase goods, it means that goods comes under the heading of stock. And stock is also one type of assets. So purchase goods for cash, it means that if you purchase the goods, that time goods comes in the business and cash goes from the business. So it also affects two accounts, cash accounts plus stock account. So here it is, purchase goods for cash. So goods comes, that comes in the heading stock. So here it is, plus 28,000, that is goods. For purchasing that goods, we will have to pay 28,000. It means that reduces over cash by rupees 28,000. It means single transaction affect two accounts, cash account as well as stock account. After that, every two lines, then we analyze that. 80,000 minus 28,000, we get 52,000. Here, there is no amount, then we get 28,000 equal to there is no any transaction, it means zero, plus the capital balance is 80,000. That is the new equation. Now, the next transaction is purchase goods on credit. It means that if you purchase the goods, that means goods comes in the business, but on credit basis. It means that net not affected over cash, that affected over creditor. And creditor is one type of liability. It means that it comes on the heading of liability. So here the transaction is purchase goods on credit. It means that goods comes in the business, that comes on the heading of stock. On credit basis, it means liability, because creditor is also one type of liability. So here the transaction affects two accounts, stock account plus creditor account. Now after every two lines we equate the equation. 52,000 minus 0, we get 52,000. 28,000 plus 20,000, we get 48,000. Here 0 plus 20,000, we get 20,000. 80,000 plus 0, that is 80,000. That is new equation. Now the next equation is purchase furniture for cash. It means that furniture is not coming on the heading goods, because furniture is a assets. If you purchase the furniture, that time furniture comes in the business and cash goes from the business. So it affects two accounts, furniture account plus cash account. Now one more heading comes in the asset side, that is furniture. So here if you purchase the furniture, that comes under heading furniture, that is 6,000, because furniture comes in the business, that is positive effect. And for purchasing furniture, we have to pay 6,000 rupees. So that reduce over cash. So 50,000 minus 6,000, we get 46,000. Then 48,000 plus 0, we get 48,000. And that is 6,000. Here, same balance, 20,000 plus 0, that is 20,000. 80,000 plus 0, that is 80,000. Now, the next equation is paid rent. If anything that is paid, that affect two account, cash account plus capital account. So here paid rent, it reduces over cash as well as over capital. So 46,000 minus 2,000, we get 44,000. Second one is same. Now the whole equation is same. Here 20,000 and 80,000 minus 2,000, we get 78,000. That is new equation. Now the next heading is received commission. If anything paid, that reduces two balances, cash account plus capital account. If anything received, that affect two accounts, cash plus capital, but in positive side. So here the transaction is new equation. We write off from this side 44,000, 48,000, 6,000, 20,000 and 78,000. Then received commission 500, and in the capital side also 500. Then we get 44,000, because 44,000 plus 500, that is 44,500. Here 48,000, that is 6,000, 20,000, 78,000 plus 500, that is 78,500. Now the next equation is withdraw cash for private use. That means that is drawing. Drawing also affects two accounts, cash account plus capital account. So 3,000 deducted from cash and 3,000 deducted from capital. Then we get 41,500, 48,000, 6,000, 20,000 and 78,500 minus 3,000, we get 75,500. Then the next equation is sold goods on credit. And the cost price of the goods, that is 30,000. It means that we purchased the goods on 30,000 and we sold the goods on 40,000. It means that the 30,000 goods, that is the cost price, and the selling price is 40,000. We get the profit, and that profit affects our capital account by rupees 10,000. So here it is 10,000 added in the capital account. And over goods or stocks reduced from 30,000, because the cost price of the stock is 30,000. So stock reduced by 30,000. And if goods are sold on credit basis, that comes on the heading of debtors. So stock reduces from 30,000, debtors increases from 40,000, and the difference between 30 and 40, that is 10,000, that is over profit, it affects over capital account. Then the new equation is 41,500, 48,000 minus 30, that is 48,000 minus 30,000, that is 18,000, and 6,000, 40,000, 20,000, and 15,500. Then the new equation is 41,500, 48,000 minus 30,000, we get 18,000, 6,000, 40,000, 20,000, and 85,500. Then the next equation is paid to creditors. If we paid something, that reduces over cash. And to whom we paid? To creditors. It means it also reduces over creditors' balance. So here it is 15,000. Decrease from cash as well as from creditors. So 41,500 minus 15,000, we get 26,500. Then here 18,000 and 6,000, 40,000, 20,000 minus 15,000, that is 5,000, and 85,500, then we get 85,500. So here the actual balance is 18,000, not this amount, that is 18,000. Then the new equation is purchase goods for cash 20,000, on credit 30,000. It means that we purchase two categories of goods, 20,000 in cash and 30,000 on credit. It means that 20,000 on cash, that increases over stock balance by 20,000, and that reduces over cash balance by rupees 20,000. And that is the second transaction, that is 30,000 purchased on the basis of credit. It means that goods comes in the business but not affected to our cash account. It affected to our creditors account. So 30,000 in the column of goods as well as 30,000 in the column of creditor. So there are two transactions, 20,000 and 30,000. 20,000 affects in cash basis, 30,000 affect on credit basis. So that 20,000 affect two accounts, cash account plus stock account. We increase 20,000 in stock account and we reduce 20,000 in cash account. The second transaction on credit basis, if we purchase something on credit, that affect two accounts, stock account and creditors account. So we increase 30,000 in the stock and 30,000 in the creditor. Then we get 26,500 minus 20,000, we get 6,500. Then same 18,000 plus 50,000, that is 60, 30 plus 20, that is 50, and plus 18, that is 68,000. Then 6,000, 40,000, 35,000, and 85,500. Then the new equation is sold goods for cash basis of rupees 10,000 and credit basis of rupees 15,000 on a profit of 20%. It means that, like upper point, we purchase two category of goods. Here we sell two category of goods, one on the basis of cash and other on the basis of credit. So first of all, on the basis of cash, 10,000 goods sold on the profit basis of 20%. So what is the 20% of 10,000? That is 2,000. So 20% of 10,000, that is 2,000, that is over profit. So here over stock reduces by 10,000, we get the profit, that is 2,000, we show in the column of capital, and after selling that goods, we receive the cash of rupees 12,000. Then credit, we sold the goods, that cost price of the goods, that is 15,000. It means we reduce the stock account by rupees 15,000 on the basis of profit. It means 20% profit. So 20% of the 15,000, that is 3,000, and profit affect over capital account. And if goods sold on the credit basis, that comes under the heading of debtors. So debtors also comes in the heading of assets. So here one more column is prepared of debtors. So that is 18,000. After analyzing all the equation, we get the new equation. So here 6,500 plus 12,000, that is 18,500. 68,000 minus 10,000 minus 15,000, we get 68 minus 23, 45,000. Then 6,000, 40,000 plus 18,000, that is 58,000, 35,000 and 85,000 plus 5,000, that is 90,500. Then rent received, if anything received, that affected two accounts, cash account plus capital account. So here it is, cash account plus capital account. Then we get the new equation after analyzing this. Then invested in shares by rupees 5,000. Invested in shares also affect two accounts. If we invest in the form of share, that reduces over cash balance and that increases over shares. Shares also comes under the heading of assets. So shares and here that 5,000 comes under the heading of shares and that reduces over cash balance. Then we get the new equation, 28,500 minus 5,000, we get 23,500. Then 45,000, then 6,000, 58,000, 5,000, 35,000 and 1,500,000. Then next one is paid cash for household expense. That is also drawing. We already discussed that point. Drawing affects two accounts, cash account plus capital account. So here we reduce in the column from cash as well as from capital. Then we get the new accounting equation. Then the last point is deposit into bank. If we deposit cash in the bank column, that increases over bank balance and that reduces over cash balance. So bank is also one type of assets. So it also comes in the asset side, that is bank. So here it is, bank increases by rupees 10,000 and cash reduces by rupees 10,000. After that we get the new equation, 16,500 minus 10,000, that is 6,500, that is 45,000. Here also 45,000, 6,000, 58,000, 5,000, 10,000, and here the balances are same, 35,000 and 93,500. After that, our accounting equation is finished. One more question of accounting equation is, if the capital of a business is rupees 1 lakh, and the liabilities is 60,000. So calculate total assets. So what is the formula of that? Is assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Here, what is given in the question? That is capital balance is given. And liabilities is also given. So we put in the front of liabilities, that is 60,000. That is liabilities balance. That is capital balance. After adding both, we get asset. That is 1,60,000. Here, one more question is, A commenced business on 1st April 2017 with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. It means capital is given. On 31st March 2018, his assets were also given 7,80,000. Liabilities is given, that is 70,000. Find out his closing capital and profit. So first of all, we will have to calculate closing capital. And what is the formula of closing assets minus closing liabilities? Closing assets, that is given in the question, that is 7,80,000 minus closing liabilities, that is also given, that is 70,000. We get closing capital, assets minus liability, then we get capital, that is closing capital. And that capital is opening capital because that capital belongs from 1st April 2017. It means that is opening capital. And we calculate closing capital with the formula assets minus liability. So here we get two balances, closing capital as well as opening capital. And the difference between closing capital and opening capital is called profit. So what is the formula of profit? That is closing capital minus opening capital. We calculate closing capital, that is 7,10,000. And opening capital, that is given in the question, is 5 lakh. Then the difference between closing capital and opening capital, we get the final balance, that is profit.